Hello everyone, I'm Weifeng from the University of Hong Kong. Today, I'm here to introduce our deep transfer learning pipeline called Selective Joint Fine Tuning. Deep neural networks require a large amount of training data. When there is insufficient data, overfitting occurs. Given a small data set, there are two popular pipelines to overcome this. The first stream is to use a pre-trained deep model as a fixed feature extractor. The second one is to run some iterations to fine-tune a pre-trained deep model. Such fine-tuning needs to be stopped before overfitting occurs. Suppose we have a small training set, which is not enough for deep learning. Naturally, we would like to add additional images as training data. Such additional images should share similar characteristics with that in the existing training set. Then, these additional images can make convolutional kernels in neural networks much more powerful and discriminative. Here we emphasize the low-level characteristics, because low-level characteristics can collect much more larger, much more images than using high-level contents. Based on these observations, we propose a pipeline called Selective Joint Fine Tuning. Similar to multitask learning, we use a single network to learn for two different learning tasks. The original learning task with insufficient training data is called a target task. The additional learning task with huge amount of training data is called a source task. Now look at the two learning tasks in a low-level feature space. For each sample in the target task, we select the nearest neighbors from the source domain. Then all these nearest neighbors form the new training set of the source task. Both of the two learning tasks are used to train a set of shared convolutional layers. Finally, there are two classifiers that generate final results in two potential different label spaces. The key difference for multitask learning is that our goal is to improve in the performance of the target task, not the source task. Actually, we use the histogram of face filter responses as our low-level feature space. For filter responses, we have two options. The first one is GABA filters. The second one is convolutional filters in CNN. Note that convolutional filters together with nonlinear activations is actually nonlinear filters. In practice, we use the first two layers in NXNet as our choice. Here is a visualization of the filter banks. Left shows the first layer of NXNet. Middle shows the GABA filters. Many filters in these two filter banks look very similar. The table here validates our choice of filter banks. Here we wish to show some of the retrieved nearest neighbors. For each row corresponds to a different target domain. These nearest neighbors share similar low-level characteristics, but different high-level contents. For example, a dog here, two kids there. Now we see some results. For fine-grained classification, the green line is our baseline. We use the green line as our baseline, which performs conventional fine-tuning without source domain. In its baseline, we use a 152-layer residual network. It actually is 80.4%. If we perform joint fine-tuning with all the source samples, it increases to 85.6%. If we use selective joint fine-tuning, the results further jumps to 90.2%. For thin classification, if we use ImageNet as the source domain, the results just become slightly better. If we switch to places instead, the results increase by 3%. All codes and models are released on GitHub. Thank you.